Finally, it is here. Actually, you guys only had to wait like 8 hours because that's how I've been. You haven't had to wait at all. Stop complaining. But it is here, part three of our Get a Shopify Store to $50 a Day Within 3 Days video series. In this series, if you forgot or you're just new here, be sure to go. If you're new here, go in the description. There's a link to video one so you can start from the beginning. But we are literally building a Shopify store from scratch, getting it to $50 a day income within 3 days, and sharing the entire process with you. Now, in this final video, we're going to get into how to generate the traffic and the ads behind it, and then we're just going to show you at the end of the video the store making $50 a day. It's pretty damn simple. So let's do it. Again, this is not me teaching this video. It's my buddy Justin, who made these videos for me a while ago. And enjoy. Have fun. There's nothing being sold here either. Have a good time.
Hey everybody, Justin Sener here. Welcome back. We're in part three, getting this store off the ground. We have our store set up and we have our products added. Let me just show you those again. All right, we have the potty golf. We have the golf ball grabber, our free plus shipping item. Here's our full price item. And we have everything set up in the back end. We have our store looking good. It looks good on mobile as well. So the next step is obviously to start driving traffic. And as I've hinted at throughout the first two videos, we're going to be using Facebook ads to drive very, very targeted traffic to our site. On Facebook ads, we definitely want to focus on sending advertising or spending advertising dollars on a product-to-product basis, meaning, we're not going to create an ad for the store in general. We're not going to create an ad for even the collections page where it lists products. We're looking to create ads for actual products. So, one ad to one product. And, the easiest way to start, as I referenced before, is doing free plus shipping. It's very easy, obviously. The proposition here is we're selling a free item, collecting shipping to offset our cost. And we're going to make a little bit of profit, but we're going to basically test and prove the niche and kind of prove our targeting, or more or less kind of find the good targeting. We're going to try to identify the best ways to target inside of our niche. We'll talk about that in a minute. And the only way to prove that is by actually spending some ad dollars and getting results. So that's what we're going to do in this section. Without a doubt, we want to use Facebook ads, like I said. So now just think about the idea that, about this product and about this whole store in general. And, when you think about marketing, take it back to the simplest form, it's all about matching your product or service with the right customer. So thankfully, Facebook makes that super easy. And you all know why Facebook ads are so powerful, even if you've never used them. And it's actually because of all of us, the users. We make Facebook ads so powerful because we're constantly feeding tons and tons of data to Facebook. We're liking pages, we're commenting on posts, we're sharing posts, and now all the different emotions, that we're able to put on top of the like button. There's all these different things, all these different data points that we're sending into Facebook. We're basically creating the marketer's dream. There's so much information out there. And it's all super relevant, and it's all targetable inside of the Facebook ads ecosystem. So we have a golf store, and remember the idea, we want to match our product to the right customer. So obviously we need to target people who like golf. And more specifically in this case, we need to target people who play golf, right? Because this is an actual utility item. This isn't just a novelty. So this is going to be something that someone who plays golf would actually want to use. So, this could be maybe when we start targeting this, and again, we're going to start with our free plus shipping item. But when we do eventually go into this and start targeting for this, this can be more, obviously people who play golf, also golf enthusiasts, golf fans, things like that. That's going to expand our targeting a little bit. So going back to this first item that we're going to start with, we know that someone who would get excited by this product is someone who plays golf. So we need to, plan or set up a plan and strategy to target people who play golf. So, we need to prove a couple things. First of all, we need to prove that you can target golf in general on Facebook. And I spoke about this when we were talking about, building the site right from the start. We can easily make the assumption that golf is a niche that does sell. I mean, that's just, there's golf stores, people who are super passionate about golf, it definitely, it's very easy to prove that you could find people who like golf on Facebook. Now, I'll show you just exactly how you can do it right now. And this tool that I'm about to bring over is called the Audience Insights tool. And you get to it by going to facebook.com/ads/audience_insights. You could also just find it, inside of tools in your ads manager. So here's facebook.com/ads/manage. this is your you know, your ads dashboard, and this is just a test account I'm showing you, but you can go to Tools and Audience Insights, and that's going to bring you to this page. So this is kind of like a research tool that that Facebook provides. Let me just get out of this and start over so you could see how to do it. So you go into the Audience Insights tool, and you could basically see people that are in your audience just by entering a few keywords over here in the interest box. So, you know, we're doing golf, and let's say we want to prove that there's enough people on Facebook to target, you know, to effectively sell product to. So I'm just going to put the main keyword golf in here. And, you know, right over here is some great information for you, right? 20 to 25 million active people are involved in the golf niche on Facebook. So are you thinking, you know, can you sell to the golf niche? Well, you obviously can sell to the golf niche, 20 to 25 million people in this niche. You know, if you have a smaller niche, you know, I would go as small as maybe even 500,000 for some very targeted niches. So obviously you can see 20 to 25, that's just a tremendous amount. It's a huge audience. Some other interesting information here, you know, age and gender of the people that like golf on Facebook. You might be surprised that it's a slight majority of women. You know, there's going to tell you some other stuff about the people that like golf. You could even narrow down, you could start adding more interests, more golf-related interests in this box. We'll do that in a second. First, I'll show you some other interesting things on here. We got the page like section, and this is going to be really important in a few minutes when we start talking about building our first audience. You know, an audience on Facebook is made up of different interests that you can target. So these are various interests over here. Obviously, you know, when we're dealing with golf, you're going to see things like PGA Tour. That's the Professional Golfers Association, like the major leagues. You know, here's a professional golfer, a big one. Here's Sports Center. Obviously, has to do with sports. You know, Rory McIlroy. You know, like I said, the big golfer. A brand. You know, a television station. You know, a big golfer. A brand. Another brand. You know, so we're starting to already see what potentially we can use to target people who like golf. So let's say we're targeting someone that likes the PGA Tour. You can make a pretty good assumption that they like golf. You know, I'm not going to like the PGA Tour if I don't have any interest in golf or watching golf, you know. Now, SportsCenter, that might not be a good one to target because, you know, you may like SportsCenter. You might not have any interest in golf, right? Golf is not a big part of SportsCenter. You know, Golf Channel. You're not liking the Golf Channel just because it's, you know, it's one of the channels that you have on your cable box. You know, you're going to like Golf Channel because you have a legitimate interest in golf. You know, same with Nike Golf, right? It's not Nike, the overall brand, but Nike Golf, you know, if I like wearing Nike clothing, I'm not liking Nike Golf. I'm only liking Nike Golf if I actually, you know, probably have some interest in golf. So that's, you know, at the simplest form, that's the idea. We're matching up customers to our product. Our product is golf related, and customers inside of these audiences are going to be, you know, have a high propensity to want to buy golf related items. So, you know, really don't make it more complex than that. You need to just find, you know, find the interests where your buyers are coming from, or where the buyers potentially will come from. So again, we could use these, and we'll use these in a few minutes to start building our interests. But other ways to leverage this tool, we could actually just start to add more interest in here. So an easy way to do that is to take the ones that you already see on here and start adding them in. So I'm going to start with the first one and put PGA Tour up here, and you're going to see that these likes change a little bit. And we could see more down here and see some other stuff. We could sort by affinity, which is kind of the go-to metric that people will use to see what is most relevant for the niche. We could see some more things here that may or may not be related. You know, I think we could also see some themes, right? So we have right here, these two right here, Rory McIlroy, Tiger Woods, both of them are big you know, athletes, big golfers. So maybe we want to target people who like the professional golfers. I think probably one of the best ones is actually smacking us right in the face here. The first one, and down here, Nike Golf. These are brands, right? These are golf-related brands. You might have a TaylorMade golf club, or you might have a Nike golf ball or whatever. You know, if you like these brands, there's a pretty good chance that you not only like golf, but play golf. And remember, we want to target people who play golf because we are working with this product. So let's see what else we have on here. You know, a lot of these don't seem to be super relevant in terms of golf. So what we could do is come back up here and maybe remove one of these and see what other things we could add back in. So how about we add in one of the brands? You know, let's add in TaylorMade Golf. Okay, and now we have some more. So remember, Golf Channel came up. Maybe we target people who watch golf-related programs on TV. And, you know, this is the way that you want to be thinking in terms of, like, kind of, you have the niche of golf and you have individual interests here. You want to find interest groups of similar interests. So, you know, the brand's interest group could be TaylorMade and Nike Golf and Titleist and all the other golf brands. And if you don't know any other golf brands, it's totally okay. You know, I don't know a lot of golf brands, but I easily can find out. All I need to do is go to Google and type in something like best golf equipment brands, you know, or best golf brands, and just see what comes up and just look through. You know, it only takes a couple seconds and I could find other brands. You know, Callaway is one. Here's TaylorMade, Titleist, Nike, Cleveland, Mizuno, Adams, right? All these other things that we can now target if we wanted to go down that route of targeting interests related to brands inside of golf. So we're not just trying to you know, put all these into one. You know, we want to find very similar interests and group them together. So there's going to be a lot of benefits to doing that. And this is what I teach all my coaching students, really go in depth in terms of how to identify the best interest groups to target. And also how to build very powerful interest groups. What I want you to focus on, and especially what we're going to focus on just for these ads, is keeping our interests organized. So, you know, just for the simple reason is figuring out what works so we can go back to it later. So I want to, you know, I'm thinking that we can do ads on a couple things. We could do an ad to this product, and we could advertise it to people who like golf brands. We could then do another ad, same product, and we could advertise it to people who like golf celebrities or athletes or professional golfers, right? Rory McIlroy, Tiger Woods, Phil Mickelson, you know, all the big pros. And again, if you don't know them, just go to Google. Most popular golfers, see what comes up. You know, here's all like probably, you know, 10 or 15 right here that we can plug right into the to our Facebook ads and, you know, our Facebook ads targeting, and we'll be good to go. So that's another one. Maybe we look for more golf channels, like Golf Channel. I don't know if there's any other, like Golf TV. Another good one to often look for is like golf magazines. And, you know, sure, it's not coming up here, but all you need to do is just think about, you know, the idea of finding subcategories within the golf niche. So magazines could be one. Big golf courses, I think, could be another one. Obviously, the brands, the celebrities that we talked about, you know, the TV channels. Maybe some of the, you know, the bigger professional events like the Masters and the U.S. Open and the British Open, you know, those can be a category. So we want to find all these different categories, and then we're going to pick our best ones and we're going to build some ads to them. And, you know, we have zero idea if these are going to work or not. You know, no one has any idea. No one can tell you if something is going to work or not. You need to just put some money up and, you know, start collecting data. So our plan is we're going to do at least two variations of our ad. One is going to go to brands. Another one is going to go to celebrities. And then we may do a third one. So, you know, pretty simple right there. That's all we need to do in terms of research to get started. Now it's time to actually build our ad. And a prerequisite to doing that is we need to build a Facebook fan page. Every single Facebook ad that you make needs to have a Facebook fan page. So it's super easy to do that. Obviously, it's free. You know, if you've never done it, I'm going to show you, you know, just how quick it's going to be. So I'm over here on facebook.com/page. It's going to redirect you, you know, to over here. So facebook.com/page, go over here and you can make a new page. And there's different categories. You know, you could do brand or product, you know, whatever. Most likely you're going to be doing something over here if you could find your category. You know, I'm just going to do website. You know, website is a pretty easy one to always do. And now I'm going to make my fan page for Golf King. So we're just going to click through. It's going to create our page. We can put in a little description. Okay, we could save all this. You know, we can come back and do this a little bit later. Now what we need to do is upload a profile image, and you guys have probably done this before. I'm just going to show you, you know, how super easy it is. I'm going to pull over, I'm going to bring the logo into Photoshop. And for the most part, they're wanting a square image. So I'm just going to change the image here to make sure that it's a square. Okay. I'm going to save it. Going back here, now I'm just going to find the file that I just created. And I'm going to, let's see, where is it? Oh, here it is, okay. So I'm putting the Facebook logo up. It's just uploading right now. There you go, matching our site and everything, you know, super easy. Skipping through this, not important. You can skip through this, not really important at this point. You know, you're gonna wanna spend some time and customize your page. You know, you could add a, you know, add a cover photo. Maybe you wanna put some other posts in here so you don't just have your, you know, your basic post, you know. Maybe you're gonna find a golf related article. You're just gonna wanna seed some content in here to make it, you know, look like this isn't like a brand new page. You know, I think that's just the one thing that you wanna avoid. So, you know, I'm not gonna spend time doing that right now, but you would customize your page, make it look all nice and pretty and trustworthy. So now that you have the page, you could actually go into Facebook Ads now and create an actual ad. So let's do that. We're just at our Facebook Ads page, and we're going to go to Create Ad. So now we have some options here, and there are different types of ads that that we want to do. And one of the ads that we can do is a page post engagement ad. So this is basically a boosted post. You know, we're going to have a post that sits on your fan page, and you're going to basically get more, try to get more engagement to it. Very popular ad type, very effective, especially when you have a very passionate niche. Now, the ad type that I always go to is website conversion ad. And think about it, you know, we're trying to sell a product, right? So we need conversions. The website conversion ad, it leverages the Facebook pixel, which we'll need to you know, install on our site. But it leverages the Facebook pixel and all the data that you eventually get into the pixel. It uses that to create, you know, or optimize your ads for conversions, aka purchases. So this is, you know, definitely the, in my opinion, the best ad type out there. This is what I'm teaching all my students. This is what I'm running myself. This is what we're going to start with. So increase conversions on your website. We're going to go here. And now what it's going to do is ask us to enter in the URL that we need to promote. So obviously, super simple. That is going to be our actual URL for our product. And here it is. All we need to do is just copy our page URL. Remember, we're going to be doing ads directly to the product. So going back over here, enter that here. And we have our product. Now we need to add our purchase pixel. So there's a couple different pixels that you can do for the Facebook pixel. You could optimize for purchases, you could optimize for add to carts, you could optimize just for page views. In my opinion, again, we're trying to sell product. The only thing I want to optimize for is purchase. I don't care if I have a brand new pixel, which is the case here, I'm still doing purchase. Okay, so don't worry about it if this is red. You know, it's not going to turn green until you get a couple purchases in there. So don't be alarmed if you have it in here. I'm going to show you how to install the code very quickly. You know, there's a, basically you're gonna have to edit your code inside of Shopify, or you're gonna have to hire someone to do it, or you can get one of the few apps that are out there that kind of you know, make it a little bit easier. But I'll show you how to do that after this. So we're setting up our website conversion ad. We're gonna name it, and I'm gonna call it you know, Golf Ball Grabber Ad 1. Okay. I'm going to go to the next step, and this is where we actually enter in our targeting. So you see right here, it says, who do you want to reach, you know, who do you want your ads to reach, okay? And this is going to be where you put in your targeting. And remember what we talked about when we were doing our research earlier, we were thinking that we could find interest related to golf brands and related to golf celebrities. So we're going to move forward with that. We're going to do the first one, and we're going to build our audience based off of golf brands. So we're just going to go through the line here. Custom audiences, this would be something that you would you know, focus on a little bit later, like your retargeting audiences. So don't worry about this right now. United States is where we're going to start. And I like to change the age to about 20. I want to start at 20 years old because I want to guarantee everyone has a credit card. So I'm doing 20. You know, I'm not going to make any assumptions about the gender here. I'm just going to start with both. And in fact, if you remember over here, it told us that there was actually more female than male. So, you know, I'm just going to keep both open. You know, I encourage you not to go with any assumption. Just kind of go both to start and see how the data, you know, let the data dictate what should happen. So here in this detailed targeting box, this is where we're going to start to enter our interest. And in this type of ad, we want to target golf brands. So let's see, going back to here, let's look at the ones that we've already identified. We have TaylorMade Golf, and we have Nike Golf. So let's put those in. And it's as simple as just typing those in to add them into our interest box. So this right here, the detailed targeting, that's what I'm calling the interest box. This is where we're going to search out and place interests to build the targeting of our ad. So let's add TaylorMade Golf. Okay, now take a look. There's a couple of them. If you look here, it says the type of the interest. So this is an employer. So this is literally the 2,344 people who work for TaylorMade Golf. And here are the people who like TaylorMade Golf. We want to go with this one. Okay, so we're going to click it. It gets added to our list. And right now, you can see up here, it says we're targeting 270,000 people. Now, here's the coolest part about Facebook ads. As you see right here, they've already recommended 6 different golf brands that, you know, we might not have even found. You know, all we needed to do was type in one that they gave us on the Audience Insights page. And now Facebook is smart enough to say, here are some other very relevant ones. So let's start adding them. You know, we know Callaway is a brand. I know Ping is a brand. And if I didn't know, I could just simply go to Google and say, and type in Ping Golf and check it out, you know. Echo Golf, you know, see what other brands there are. So nothing else that they're recommending. We know that there's also Nike Golf, right? There you go. And maybe we didn't know any other brands. Remember, we could just make that simple Google search for golf brands, top golf brands, most popular golf brands, whatever. And now we see a lot more. So we could sit here and add all these. You know, I'm just going to add some of the other big ones in here, like Titleist. And let's just add Titleist and go from there. Okay, so we added some golf brands here. The thing to remember here is that we're looking for very similar interests, because what we want to do is hopefully get sales from this this ad. And if we do get sales, then we know that that buyers come from the group made up of people who like golf brands. And that's extremely powerful. You know, that's something that, you know, we can build a lot of our marketing off of, and, you know, a lot of the products that we sell, knowing that we can target successfully people that like these golf brands and that they will wind up buying. That's basically priceless information. You know, there's tons and tons of products out there, but there's only so many interest groups. So when you can identify a winning interest group, it's going to be a lot of money in your pocket. So we're going to definitely hope that this one turns into sales. If it does, what we're going to do moving down the road is launch more products and do this exact same targeting. So the research that you do at the beginning is super important. It's going to kind of stick with you for the entirety of your time in the niche. So here's our targeting. We got 1.8 million people that we're going to reach in this ad. And now we're going to talk about how much do we want to spend. We want to start all of our ads at $5. You know, all it takes is $5 to get started. You know, of course, people aren't making millions of dollars per month spending $5 on ads, but it's a great way to get started. I'm typically going to spend $5 a day for 3 to 5 days before making any decisions on whether to cut or continue my ad. So, you know, maybe if I make like 5 or 6 sales on the first day, I'll start to scale my budget. Otherwise, I'm going to let the ad play out over 3 to 5 days and see how it goes. Reason why that's super important is not because, you know, I just have a higher risk tolerance than you. That's not the case. It's because with a website conversion ad, Facebook takes time to optimize the ad. So if you were just to make a decision off of one day, $5, you wouldn't have really given Facebook a fair opportunity to go and optimize that ad. So I recommend 5 days. You know, if you're going to cut it at something lower, make it 3 days at least. Okay, so we're going to do $5. You could schedule it if you want. I'll often just, you know, start it whenever I'm going, and you could name the ad set if you wanted to. Now the next part is where we're actually going to build our ad creative. So here is where we are going to actually create the ad. And the cool thing about Facebook ads is they are what's called native ads. So they're going to fall right into your news feed. So here's, you know, the desktop news feed. Someone's going to scroll through and they're going to see this exact thing. You know, it just looks like a post from any page. You know, we're obviously going to go and pick the, we'll pick the golf page right now. So Golf King. So we'll pick the page to connect to. And these are going to be the different placements that we'll get. We'll get desktop news feed. We'll get mobile news feed. We could have Instagram if we want. We could have audience network. As you see here, it's like a mobile ad network. We could do the right-hand side column. What I want you to focus on is just the news feed. So turn everything else off. But news feeds are by far the best placement on Facebook. And again, playing into that native ad idea, apart from the word sponsored up here, it's going to look just like any other post in anyone's news feed. That's why these ads are so powerful. So now we're going to actually build our ad. So you see here, there's a headline, there's text, there's a call to action button. You can see these in place right here, and we can edit them live. So I like doing something, you know, very simple, like, you know, do you like golf? I like playing with questions, you know? So I'll have this, and you'll see it update, do you like golf? And remember, we're going to be advertising this specific product. So, you know, we're going to put some type of language in our ad that is relevant to this product. You know, again, I like doing questions. Do you like golf? Do you hate bending over to grab your golf ball? Click. Now for, we want to play on the idea that it's free plus shipping. And here's a caveat with the free plus shipping things. We don't want to be deceptive at all. So we don't want to say free and then, you know, hide the fact that they have to pay shipping. We should be very upfront. So I like putting something like this. Get it for free, just pay for shipping. Okay, so now we'll take a look at our ad. Here's some nice copy. You know, the questions are cool. You